And we are back.
Hi, guys.
Welcome to Leave Reacts. I hope everyone's having a good day. I know I am. Tuckered out, as usual. Them damn kids, man. They're fast, and I'm just getting slow, man. I swear to God. I still got it, but she's quick. She'll be 3 in like 2.5 weeks, man, and she's just... good Lord. But here we are, back with Miss Joni Mitchell, and we're going to be listening to Blue once again. We did the first 3 tracks last week. I'll link it right up there if you want to watch part 1. This is going to be the next 3 songs, which is Carey, Blue, and California. I don't know. There's just something about her music and her writing and just her heart, her whole artistic approach. It's so honest and so refreshing. I see why Bob Dylan took some time off after listening to this, because I see it just completely changed the game, because there was no more wall, you know. She just tore it down and it was just her, you know. So I think that's a beautiful thing, and the music is even better. So here we go. This is also brought to you by our patron and sponsor, Gail H. She requested this album, I think, like about a month ago now, and we haven't looked back since. Thank you very much, Gail. I appreciate your support. Alrighty, first up is Carey by Miss Joni Mitchell in 3, 2, 1, go.
The wind is in from Africa. Last night I couldn't sleep. Oh, you know it sure is hard to leave here, Carey, but it's really not my home. My fingernails are filthy. I've got beach tar on my feet. And I miss my clean white linen and my fancy French cologne. Oh, Carey, get out your cage. Glasses down. Let's have a round for these freaks and these soldiers. A round for these friends of mine. Let's have another round for the bright red devil who keeps me in this tourist town. Come on, Carey, get out your cage. Or maybe I'll go to Rome and rent me a grand piano and put some flowers around my room.
This one has some joy in it.
But let's not talk about fare-thee-wells now. The night is a starry dawn, and they're playing that scratchy rock and roll beneath the mantle moon. Come on, Carey, get out your cage. I couldn't sleep. Oh, you know it sure is hard to leave you, but it's really not my home. Maybe it's been too long a time since I was scrambling down in the street. Now they got me used to that clean white linen and that fancy French cologne. Oh, Carey, get out your cage.
That one didn't feel so blue. I'm guessing the next one will, though. I like that a lot.
Blue. before. Crown and anchor me, or let me sail away. Hey blue, there is a song for you, ink on a pin.
Beautiful soundscape, man. So sparse, but full of life at the same time.
Everybody's saying that hell's the hippest way to go. Well, I don't think so, but I'm gonna take a look around at the blue.
Such a subtle atmosphere to this one.
There is your song from me.
Oh. Wow. What a release that was. That one felt blue. God, she really does have the soul of a poet, man. That made me feel things.
Sitting in a park in Paris, France, reading the news and it sure looks bad. They won't give peace a chance. That was just a dream some of us had. Still a lot of lands to see, but I wouldn't want to stay here. It's too old and cold and settled in its ways here.
Canada.
All the California, California, coming home. I'm gonna see the folks I dig. I'll even kiss a sunset pig. California, I'm coming home.
Her acoustic is just so good.
I met a redneck on a Grecian Isle who did the goat dance very well. He gave me back my smile, but he kept my camera to sell. Oh, the rogue, the red, red rogue. He cooked good omelets and stews, and I might have stayed on with him there, but my heart cried out for you. California, oh, California, coming home. Oh, make me feel good, rock and roll band. I'm your biggest fan, California, I'm coming home. The streets are full of strangers, all a new zone. You read, just give you the blues. Just give you the blues.
Wow.
So I bought me a ticket, I caught a plane to Spain. To a party down a red dirt road. There were lots of pretty people there, reading Rolling Stone, reading Vogue. I said, how long can you hang around? I said, a week, maybe two, just until my skin turns brown. And I'm going home to California, California. as I am, strung out on another man, California, I'm coming home.
Her, the way she writes, man, I don't even know how to explain it. It's so good.
When you're walking and the streets are full of strangers, all the news at home you read, more about the war and the bloody changes. Oh, will you take me as I am? Will you take me as I am?
Question. Will you take me as I am? Shit, now I want to go to California. Northern California. Way north. My best friend growing up, his older sister lived out in Oregon, and she lived right on the California border, and she said it was the most beautiful place she'd ever seen, and she traveled a lot. They used to be Amish, and they I guess quit being Amish and then traveled a bunch, and yeah. But anyways, now I want to go to California. And I don't know if it was about Joni Mitchell and this song, but didn't Led Zeppelin write Going to California about her? Maybe it's about somebody else. I can't remember. I could be wrong. But man, what a talent she has at just like conveying an emotion or a story or just anything, and she can just write so well, and the cadence of everything is just so smooth and eclectic at the same time. You know, it's very different. I've never heard anybody who sings exactly like her. She's got a very unique stylized voice and like the way that she sings, and I think it's beautiful, man. I think she has such a gorgeous voice. And she's got such a gorgeous inner voice as well. Like, what she's trying to say and convey, it's all, I think, like, looking at life for what it is. And I think, you know, for what she wants it to be as well, obviously. But I feel that, especially that the title track, Blue, that one definitely felt a little sad. The other two kind of actually brought to mind hope and feeling alive and young, and but the middle one, it definitely had a lot of reflections in it for me. I've been thinking a lot about, you know, my old friends and, you know, the life that, you know, I left. And I left so many more burnt bridges than I realized. I've been starting to realize that, you know, when I start to think of people, you know, if something ever happened or I want to talk to them or just anything, if I want to call someone or, you know, and it's, the list is pretty short, shorter than I thought, let's just say, you know, and it's kind of a sad reality, and that's a lot of, you know, bridge repairing I can, you know, do as well, but with kids and the channel and everything, you know, it's, there's not much time to even have friends, but, you know, you gotta have somebody, you know. Obviously, I've got my girl, my kids, and I love them, but at the same time, you know, I don't have any real, like, dude friends, it feels like, that I could just talk to anymore, you know, about the entire girl family I'm surrounded by. You know, I'm just the only dude, you know. It's fucking crazy sometimes, and Cheyenne doesn't get it, you know, obviously, because she's a girl, you know, but just, like, women need women to talk to, I think men need men to talk to as well, you know, and, I don't know, it's just, it sucks being outnumbered. I really am, and I'm always outvoted. But I love them to death, and I'd do anything for them. And that second track just really made me feel, I don't know, not even sad, but just melancholy, you know, just that feeling of, I don't know, things could have been so much better, you know, but they weren't, you know, they turned out the way they did, and they turned out the way they did for a reason, and I need to be okay with that. Who knows where I could go with my life and what I could do. I could do anything, you know, and it's just, it's all about your mindset and how much effort you're willing to put in. And I think if this channel is evidence enough of me putting an effort, I don't know what is, man. And I used to be the non consistency wasn't my strong suit. Let's say it. Let's put it that way. Sorry, my freaking hairs in my face. I've tried to prove to myself that I can be consistent and do something every day. And do it to the best of my ability. And I think I have, you know, and I think that's a beautiful thing because that was not my forte. And I don't know, man, just music like this, it just makes me happy to be alive. The first and third track definitely made me feel happy to be alive and joy and hopefulness, you know. The first one especially, it felt like a real love song, like, you know, actually in love, not in lust or just in love because you have to be. I felt like actual young, you know, not even puppy love, what's the word? Like just young, untethered love, you know, that's what it felt like. I don't know what the songs are about. I know Carey was, let's see, Carey was inspired by her time spent with Carey Raddatz, living in a cave-dwelling hippie community on the Greek island of Crete. Like, who is this woman? Good God, she is so interesting, man. That's so cool. That's so cool. So yeah, it is like actual love. And then Blue, it's generally thought to be about James Taylor. The line is, here's a song for you, being directed at Taylor. Blah, blah, blah. It's in references to drug addicts, needles, and proffering a seashell to her lover, making it fairly clear that Blue is about James. Well then, well, I felt blue about that one. I really did. And then California is released as the second single from the album as a follow-up to Carey. So, okay, we did that. That worked out. KCU is the B-side. And the background is Mitchell wrote California while living in France, but longing for the creative climate she had experienced in California. Oh. Well, damn. I thought she was talking about Canada. Never mind. Because I know she's Canadian, but that is... Yeah, that makes sense. I know that I didn't know that her and James Taylor were a thing. But I mean, who knows? I'm 29. I don't know the tabloids and who was screwing who back in the day. I barely know the music, you know, so I definitely don't know who was with who and stuff like that. But it's interesting to see all the connections because we've done a James Taylor track and I really, really enjoyed it. And I don't know, man. Like, I think Joni is definitely the most talented female singer and songwriter we've had on the channel, I feel like. And we've had a lot. She's up there with one of the top just artists, I feel like, just in the department of feeling, emotion, and writing ability. I mean, her lyrics are just piercing, but they're also healing at the same time. You know, like, that she can just do both. I feel like that's it takes a true artist and a true writer right there. Like, she does have the soul of a poet, and I'm very glad to be listening to this album right now because I kind of need it. Like I said, I'm processing a lot, going through a lot through proxy and by just myself at the same time, you know? And I don't know, I'm trying my best to stay focused, keep my head on straight, you know? But it's just hard, man. Like I said, like I always say, it's hard being a human and it's rich coming from me, but, you know, the man on the screen, right? But, you know, it's... The kids, man, like, I don't know, there's just so much I wish I could be doing more for them, and I don't know, I get all these compliments saying I'm a good dad and all that, but sometimes I don't feel like I am. Sometimes I feel like I could do so much better, so I try to challenge myself to be better and more patient, more kind, and, you know, more gentle, whatever I need to be, but, and I'm a father to girls, so it's different than, they're not guys, you know, they're not boys. Even though Danica is one tough little son of a bitch. She really is. man, scraped knees, scraped everything, man. She falls and just tumbles and gets right back up. She's just like her daddy. And I love her so much. And I love spending all this time with her that I've been getting. Of course, the unfortunate circumstances. But at the same time, I've definitely never felt closer to her. And yeah. Thank you for watching, guys. I appreciate it. If I had to pick a song out of that, I'd say Blue or California was my favorite. But Carey was... They're all three of them really, honestly, really strong tracks. All six so far have been strong tracks. And I'm guessing the next couple are going to be strong tracks. This lady is just unstoppable on this album. And she probably altogether is unstoppable. But I haven't heard that much technically from her, so I'm not going to make declarative statements, but for this album, this woman is, yeah, she's killing it. So thank you for watching. Thank you again to Gail H for sponsoring this video. You rock. Thank you for the support. And that is it. Y'all know we have a Patreon right here. That is a picture of it. There is a link in the description. Join the $15 tier or up. You can get one free request a month. You have one more day to join to get it this get a request this month and next month. I'm trying to leave a buffer period of a couple days. If it's not too long, if it's a short track you just want to request, I'll definitely do it. You know, I can sneak those in with the longer ones. If you're in the higher tiers, like you're going to have to wait till next month. But yeah, we'd love to have you, man. We have a great community. We have a Discord server. If you want to come chat with us, hang out. You know, I pop my head in every day. I try to. You have a great community, man. I'm very proud of all the people we have. And they know their shit about music, too. They really, really do. And thank you to everyone who sends in requests and shares their musical wisdom and knowledge with me, because I soak it up like a sponge. I really do. And I couldn't do this without you guys. So thank you. If you want to send a request, then there's also a PayPal link in the description as well. And that's for tips, requests, and anything else. Thank you for watching. I will see y'all next week for the next three tracks. Or maybe the finale of it. I might do the rest of them. It's five tracks. I don't know. That might be skating it. I'll see. We'll see. We'll figure it out. See you later.